Good morning, friends. We are with a video on Webots with Docker. So first, let's answer why Docker. So let's take two scenarios. First being, if you are someone who just wants to try out Webots without hassle of installing, for just getting feel of it, Docker is for you. Or you are a developer or a student who is working on a software and he is facing the issue of project works beautifully on his machine, but when they deploy it to customer or submit it to professor, there are some dependency issues. So if you are facing this issue, you must definitely check out Dockers. Before getting into and installing Webot Docker, let's discuss a higher level view of what is Docker. So Docker is a virtualization system which sits directly on host operating system, but it does not depend on which host operating system it is on. For example, if we have a project with three Dockers, one being for ROS, second Docker for simulator, and third Docker for web interface. So in this case, you can have ROS Docker in Linux, you can have simulator Docker maybe in Mac, and you may have web interface in Windows. Still, these three will work together and you will achieve your goal. Also, Dockers are independent when they are running. For example, if you want to close a simulator Docker, still your ROS Docker and web interface Docker will work fine. Also, it is easy to start and stop Docker. Unlike VM, there are shared resources used by Docker, which is efficient in terms of memory. Now, after looking at these features, let's go through basics of how Docker works. In order for having a container, you need to save a Docker file, then build it as an image, and you can run it as a container. After it is running successfully, if you want to make any changes in the container, you can also do the reverse, where you can save the current commit of your container as an image, and then you can deploy it. If things are a bit shaky, don't worry, we will do the practical implementation and Docker will be really easy. I would like to share a resource of a great video on Docker. The video link will be in the description. So now, let's get our hands dirty with installing Docker and seeing how Webots works with Docker. We will be looking at this installation page, which is given by Webots. So the link will be given in the description. Today we will see installation of Docker image. So if I click here, it comes to the installation of Docker image. First of all, if you don't have Docker in your system, click on install Docker. So this is the installing instructions. When you click here, select your platform. So in my case, it is Ubuntu. In Ubuntu, first of all, there is a command to remove the Docker. Then there is an installation method where you update, you add the GPG key, you echo this, and finally, when you run this command, that is when your Docker gets installed. So we can do a small check here where if you open your terminal and if you do sudo docker ps, it will ask you for superuser permissions. So currently this command is used to check that do we have any Docker running. Currently we don't have any Docker running in our system, but if you see the similar result, that means Docker is installed correctly. If this is done, we will go in the instructions further. So if you want to get the GUI out of your Webots Docker, you need to give x11 forwarding. You need to use this command, copy this command and paste it on your terminal. After running this command, we can choose between, do we need to use GPU in our system or not? If you don't want to use GPU and want to keep it easy, you can run this command with Docker run. The Docker name will be cyberbotics/vbots and the tag will be latest. When you run this command, it will show you Docker, but in our case, we are going to use GPU. So there are official instructions. So you can click here and go through NVIDIA Docker instructions. Today, in our case, we will be running this Docker run. So I'm running this with GPU. Let me copy this, Control C. If I Control V, it will not work because we need sudo. So I will add sudo in the front. So in this case, let's type vbots in our Docker. So when I hit enter, it spawns a vbots session. It is loading a scene for me. If I see, we have a spot doing sexy moves. Let me remove these for now. And for example, you can use the Docker to make your own project or just see these projects. If I want to develop a project where, for example, if I want this freight here, I want this can to be moved. And also, spot is alone. So let's add a human so that he can take care of the spot. So we have a human. So this is an example of if you want to tweak the world, and if you forget to save the world and close the Docker, you will lose all your changes. But if you save the changes, so save world as save. So in root, we will make a folder named sample and let's save this as spot human .wbt inside the sample folder. So if I click save, this thing is saved now. If I close this, this is still the Docker. And remember, we are not using vbots from our native computer. So if you open another terminal and you type sudo docker ps, so you will see here that there is a Docker running from last 5 minutes and its name is cyberbotics vbots colon latest. And if you remember correctly, we made a sample folder and we have a wbt named spothuman.wbt. Now if you hit exit and enter, you will lose all your changes. But let's assume you want to save this state of Docker. So what you can do is you can type sudo docker commit and you can put the container ID here because this is what you want to save. And you can name your Docker, let's name soft illusion sample, and we can give tag as latest. So if I hit on enter here, it saved a Docker in the current state as an image. So if I do sudo docker images, it shows me many images. We see this is the latest one. It saved our image of size 7.93 GB. So now, if I want to send this Docker image to a professor or a client, and if he opens the image, he will be able to see the same scenario. So let's do that. Let's take a new terminal and repeat the process. So we will need to do X11 forwarding. So if I copy this, If I paste it here, enter, then we can do this one, copy with GPU1, so copy, sudo, paste it, and remember, we saved our Docker with a different name, so we need to replace that name. Let's double check the name. It is Soft Illusion Sample. Let's copy it and let's paste it here. If I hit on enter, this made a new Docker for us, which was with Soft Illusion. And if I do ls sample, so you can see this is the folder which we made, and we have spot_human.wbt. So this is how, if you have a project, you can save the project by committing the Docker, and if anyone else opens your Docker, he will see the same file which you saved. So this was all about Docker, how you can run the Docker, do changes, save the commit, and share it with others. So in this case, you don't require any knowledge of how to install Webots or stuff. Everything is ready. So this was all about today's video. If you like the video, do share it with others and do try out Docker and let us know if you have any questions. Thank you.